This video is about a forbidden technique in Python, the twin snake sacrifice jutes storing mutable or non-hashable things in sets and dictionaries. Normal sets and dicts use hashing, meaning when you want to check if an element is in there, you use the element's hash to pick the exact index where the element would go if it was present, so you can just check that one location instead of checking every location. It's kind of like when you go to the grocery store and need to find the milk. You don't walk through every aisle, you just go straight to the refrigerated section, and if it's not there, then they're out. No need to check the rest of the store. But hashes are necessarily based on the state of an object in order to make hashes be different for as many different objects as possible. Hash collisions are allowed, they just degrade performance. Like if the grocery store made the whole store refrigerated, then you'd have to fall back to searching every aisle to find the milk. But if hashes are based on object state, then mutating the object would probably change its hash, so if you went to go find it later, you'd look in the wrong place. For that reason, the usual wisdom is that you shouldn't make mutable things hashable. Python tries to enforce this by defining a dunder hash for your classes by default, but not defining the hash if you define an equals function. In practice, this is a solid 6 out of 10 solution, but realistically, Python can't do any better, it can't read your mind, and there's no default that would suit every case. So if you have an opinion about whether or not your type should be hashable, then either define the hash yourself or set it to none. But sometimes you just want a set of mutable or unhashable things, so what do? You could use a list or create your own mapping or set type that stores data in a list, but this is not the forbidden technique. The problem is, looking up elements becomes incredibly slow because you lose that constant time lookup that hashing provides. You're falling back to checking every aisle in the store for the milk. Instead, let's take advantage of a key property of every Python object, its identity. Every Python object, hashable or not, mutable or not, has an integer ID that's guaranteed to be both unique and constant for the duration of its lifetime. You can access this ID by using the built-in ID function. IDs can be reused. After one object is garbage collected, its old ID could be reassigned to a new object. But as long as an object is alive, the ID is an immutable, hashable value that uniquely determines the object. I hope you see where I'm going with this. So what we're going to do is make our own mapping and set types that internally never hash the object itself, but instead hash the ID of the object. In our mapping type, we'll still use a plain old dict, but we'll map the identity of a key to its key value pair. Again, the ID of a key is just an int. It's perfectly fine to use as a key of a dictionary, regardless of whether or not the key itself is hashable. The result of looking up an ID is a key value pair. Storing the key in addition to the value ensures that the key isn't garbage collected and that the key's ID won't get reused by another object as long as this mapping exists. Getting an item now just looks up the ID of the key in the dict and returns the value. Setting an item just maps the key ID to the key value pair. And deleting an item just deletes the ID of the key from the map. There are a few other functions here, but they're pretty straightforward, and we take advantage of the collection's mutable mapping ABC to fill in the rest of the usual dictionary interface like get, pop, and so on. Our set type is similar. We keep a plain old dict of value IDs to values. Again, we're storing the value in addition to its ID to prevent values from being garbage collected while the set is still alive. Adding an element to the set means mapping its ID to its value. Discarding an element means popping its ID from the map, and checking if an element is in the set is just checking if its ID is a key in the dictionary. Once again, there are a few other pretty simple functions, and we use collections, mutable set, abstract base class to fill out the rest of the usual set interface. And there we go. We can now create a list which is not hashable, put it in our mapping or set, no problem, even mutate it in between, and we can still look it up, no problem. Mutating the list doesn't change its ID. Great, so what's the downside? The downside is that when I look up an element, I need to use the exact same object, not just an equal one. Compared to a normal set, if I add 257 in, then add int of float of 257 in, the set just has one element, 257. But if I use the ID set, the same code would add in two copies of 257 because the two 257s, although equal, are different Python objects that have different IDs. It is still a set, and it does filter duplicates, but in order to be considered a duplicate, you have to add in the exact same object twice. This can be especially confusing for small object types like ints and strings, or for types where it's not clear whether its operations mutate the object in place or return a new one back to you. I highly discourage using these types with ID mapping or ID set, and this potential for confusion is the reason this is forbidden Python knowledge. But if you're certain your objects will be stored and looked up using the exact same object, then you might find this trick to come in handy. I take no responsibility for the criticism you get in code review if you actually try this, though. It's forbidden knowledge for a reason. Thanks to me, myself, and I for sponsoring myself. In addition to making esoteric and questionable Python content on YouTube, I also run a software consulting business. If you have a project at your company that you think needs some outside eyes, check us out at mcoding.io. And of course, thank you to my patrons and donors for supporting the channel. I appreciate the support and I'm glad you find my videos useful. Don't forget to slap that like button an odd number of times, and I'll see you in the next one.